And now I would like to invite on stage Mr. Rajendra Bhat, VP of Head After Sales, TVS Motor Company. Mr. Bhat is going to give us an insight into TVS Motor After Sales innovations. Please welcome him with a big round of applause.
And thank you for all the prior speakers who have made putting my point much easier in my presentation. Any business model works like this. We start with the required enablers. In case of service, it's always people, infrastructure, machinery, processes, etc. But two things that work out as good pillars are SOPs and team. A good team, which can work in a disciplined manner on the SOPs, which can add value to the SOPs, refine it, and ultimately lead to better customer experience and productivity. This is what shop floor people can do, what workshop team can do. Next comes marketing. We have a good product called customer experience, which can be generated at our workshops. This has to be marketed to the customers. The need has to be refined. The need has to be addressed through our product and then reached out to customers through marketing. And a prudent fiscal management by the dealerships will lead to profitability. This is the core model of after sales service. In scope of my presentation, I have kept one part of SOP for discussion. The topic is innovation in after sales. I just substituted the word innovation with 3E. I'll explain what 3E is and how there is some element of innovation in this 3E. Just taking liberty of keeping some things verbal in this course of presentation. So what is the need of innovation after sales? Two-wheeler service versus two-wheeler sales. In sales process, the maximum number of visits is 3 at a dealership, whereas the journey starts in service processes, where the average number of visits is 15 in 5 years. The experience in sales is going to be for a very short period of time, maybe a few minutes or few hours during each of the visits, whereas whenever a customer visits in service, it can be 2 hours to 2 days, depending on the type of repairs. In case of slack in the process, sentiments can be revived in after sales. However, in service, a customer makes his impression quickly based on the first time right experience that he got at the dealership, and it's very difficult to regain customer save because he is going to make an impression about the person, the service advisors, and changing impression about that person, giving him another chance, is going to be very tough. So service reconfirms or reshapes a customer's image of a brand. There are customer experience expectations. People earlier spoke about how product experience, cost effectiveness, trustworthiness, and convenience are main customers' expectations. And there are dealerships and staff expectations. They want improved footfalls for sales and service. They want from the manufacturer certain competence and SOPs to meet customers' expectations. What is put here, and this is what I'll be dwelling upon in my presentation. And they will, of course, expect profits, and they'll expect recognition, gratification. Rest of the points are not in the scope of this presentation. So we are talking right now about someone who is lowermost in the hierarchy in the workshop, which is technician. His job is not so sexy. Very difficult job. Difficult to understand also. A lot of people on the top do not understand the technician's job. And he is yet the least supported, is what we felt. Now, I'll take the liberty once again of keeping this verbal. The problem statement of this presentation is that our first-time ride in certain dealerships was not as good as it should be. And we being Indian company, right from conceptualizing a product to manufacturing product, we do it in our factory in Hosur. So we need a lot of technical involvement from the grassroots level people to build a right product, to refine the product quality, and also give a delightful customer experience through product ownership. In all this, we found that there are a few bottlenecks. So first is, there was lack of speed and timeliness of capturing product issues. And even where it was being captured, somewhere due to technicians' capability of communicating the exact issue, as Mr. Narula rightly said, the capability is different from what we see in four-wheeler technicians and service advisors. So the way they express their ability to clerically and correctly convey the technical feedback is not that great. But yes, there's a lot of determination. Once we give them a task, they will go to any extent to work in any rigorous condition. I have attended a few camps in flood-affected areas, and my zonal heads introduced to some of the technicians. These technicians were staying in relief camps. Their homes was had been washed away, and you know, they were kind of living off the relief camp food, and yet they had come to workshops to put the vehicles on road. So that is the kind of dedication, and we wanted to kind of help them to express what difficulties they face in a product and how the product can be improved further. So once we have a fair understanding of the product complaints and we develop some countermeasure, we found that the training content that we developed based on product modification was only partially understood by the technician. And even if it's understood, the retention of the content was poor. And unlike four-wheelers, the cost of in-house training and quality managers is prohibitive in two-wheelers. Cannot afford to have a separate section for two-wheelers. Of course, the way the network is also designed in the company is not as, it's not similar to four-wheelers. So the scale, advantage of scale is not easily available to us. And then there were issues in tracking and monitoring of the actual practice at the workshop. So all this was leading to some challenges in meeting customer expectations. So coming back to the innovation, a small level, basic level of innovation that we talked about in the beginning, 3E, which is engage, enable, and empower with the technician here. We had to engage with him to understand his actual concern, the customer's actual concern, and we have to enable him to meet the customer's needs. And management-wise, we have to empower him. He should be able to quickly take decisions, capable of taking decisions. And this is going to come through information, communication, and technology. So this is how we are going to engage, enable, and empower. So it's pretty much the same thing. I saw in Mr. Punnavanam's presentation that the car service was pretty much what we have seen earlier, but they have brought in a lot of information, communication, technology in servicing so that the experience is much better, the clarity is much higher, right? And the chances of failure is much lesser. So the basic process aided by information, communication, and technology. First thing is to capture the voice as accurately as possible. We have digitized the operation in our workshop. The scope in this presentation, I will be keeping only about the technical inputs on the product feedback, which it doesn't get distorted when the service error directly punches in. If it gets punched through a second person, like DMS operator, the essence is generally lost. Once these problems are understood and at the back end the priorities are made, product modifications are made, the next step is to convey to the workshop what retrofitment can be carried out in the field so that the older customers get the benefit of modifications. To make understanding easy, in our portal we have given provision of downloading and viewing all our bulletins in videographic form. So the videos can be viewed by the team in the workshop, sitting in the workshop, and understand the improvement repairs that we are recommending in a better way, manner. Not stopping there, our technical team, which so far used to manage the PPFRs or field trouble reports, whatever we call, from the back end, was made to visit field more often, interact more often. And best thing that we understood after that is that instead of coming back with only complaints about the clerical inputs, they actually began appreciating the problem that our people were facing, our customers were facing. And these same guys again began interacting with our area officers and in some places with our workshop guys through Zoom calls, and gave a live demo of what modifications have to be carried out, and they were even taking the Q&As from the field directly. And also to improve our solution finding ability, we conduct technical summits in different zones throughout the year, where technicians of various dealers in an area participate and they demonstrate technical resolutions to some of the chronic problems that we are facing. And we send a panel from R&D quality who watches their presentation and awards the best presentation by the technician. And technicians also showcase special tools that they have developed for the ease of servicing. So last year, 107 ideas were generated and 66 ideas are either under active consideration or they have already been incorporated in the product improvement. Once bulletins are launched, the trainings are given, to ensure that technicians are supported by works managers. After understanding what they have been taught, we take online assessment of the works managers. It's a random test on the modifications or bulletins that has been released, along with their other competencies. And they are encouraged to participate in this test, and those who clear are given certificates. This is to improve the salience. And we track the effectiveness of all these measures through several user-friendly dashboards, and we get information till the technician level on their performance. Again, the weak technicians are called back for retraining, re-counseling, and that is how it goes on. And we have a group on WhatsApp. We call it expert group, where not waiting for regular opportunities or standard opportunities to interact. The technicians are encouraged to give feedback and raise complaints in this forum. So if some other technician knows solutions, he would immediately put it in this group. Otherwise, it is anyway being taken care of by the back end, right? Our quality people are also part of this group. To summarize these whole initiatives, 5 back-end and 6 front-end processes were digitized. Also helped the team capability in terms of better productivity, lead time reduction, quicker response. New processes were introduced. 3 new SOPs were developed. It helped improve the problem identification, idea generation capability of the team. 2 new metrics were developed. And chasing the metrics helped our team improve the implementation of countermeasures, which is quicker PDCA. And 3 new dashboards were developed. Can't put forth the results, but again, keeping this verbal, we saw wherever this was implemented at the earnest, the first time right improved by almost 6%. So that was the presentation from our side. Thank you very much for your patient listening. Can speak offline. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Bhat.